So we're here today with Jackie Dooley, and we are going to hear from Jackie about the report on special collections in the UK and Ireland. Jackie, tell us a little bit about this report and how it came to be.
Our collaborator in this report was Research Libraries UK, RLUK, which is the ARL equivalent in the United Kingdom. And they have some members in Ireland as well. And when they saw the report, that very similar report we had done surveying libraries in the US and Canada about special collections and archives, they were very interested to have one themselves. And it was facilitated by the fact that they wanted to have it be quite similar so that the data could be compared, contrasted, using the same topics and such. And they were fabulous collaborators. They, of course, know the UK landscape, mm-hmm. which I didn't at all. Now I know some. They connected me with half a dozen or so special collections librarians, distinguished experts in the field over there, who helped me do things like turn the US survey instrument into something that made sense for the UK Ireland audience. They helped just in so many ways with the strategy for promulgating it, giving presentations at some of the meetings we went to talk to the RLUK directors about the project, and helping draft parts of the report.
Mm-hmm. How similar or different is the survey instrument that you used?
Very similar. Interestingly, the UK librarians wanted to add a number of questions related to preservation, which they refer to as collections care, mm-hmm. And we had done very little of that in the U.S. project, mm-hmm. Trying to keep the survey reasonably short and focusing on issues where we felt there was a lot of potential for progress, forward movement, mm-hmm. collaboration, and such.
So what can you tell us about the survey population? What institutions were surveyed?
RLUK has 32 members, or did at the time in 2011, and all 32 responded, which was fantastic.
That's great.
One of the other things that the RLUK staff and those librarians did was helped nudge everybody into participating, mm-hmm. so they got 100% response, which was great. Many of those RLUK members are also members of our OCLC Research Library Partnership, mm-hmm. and they all participated as well. We have, about 20-some members in the UK and Ireland. And then the UK director and associate executive director invited about 50 or 60 other research libraries that are not RLUK members to participate because they want to take the opportunity to get a broader picture of the sector. And it was it was so interesting to me to learn about the rather incredible wealth of private libraries, mm-hmm. and university libraries that are not part of the RLUK membership, museum libraries with fantastic special collections, cathedral collections, so many royal societies, learned societies. So it really enhances the overview of the landscape in the UK and Ireland and shows some really major differences between the large research libraries and the others, as there would be here.
Mm-hmm. With the US and Canada survey, there had been previously some work done by ARL, mm-hmm. that we had kind of as a baseline. Was there anything similar to that in the UK?
Nope, nothing whatsoever. RLUK has done various surveys of hidden collections, mm-hmm. uncatalogued materials and such, and some other sort of pieces of the picture, but nothing at all broad-based like this.
Okay, so this gives them a basis of comparison going forward. That's great.
Yes, as it was so helpful in the US and Canada to have had the report that ARL put out in 1998 that our US report was based on.
Yeah. So what were kind of the key findings, the things that are top of mind for you, having just recently finished this whole process of survey and analysis?
Well, I can't help but think about the data somewhat comparatively, because they were two such similar projects, and RLUK had so much interest in doing that kind of comparison. Anyway, in fact, there's a section of the report that directly compares the ARL data from 2010 with that from RLUK the following year. And it was interesting to see that the most frequently mentioned major challenges, just an open-ended question, were the top ones were the same in both areas. In the UK, the absolute number one was outreach, sort of outreach writ large in terms of connecting with and servicing the whatever the audience is that that library is directed towards. And it was clear that there are a lot of aspects of outreach, particularly sort of really proactive outreach to new communities and for new reasons, that strike special collections librarians in the UK as a huge challenge, for which they're going to need a lot of reskilling. Different aspects of outreach were a challenge here, but that was really quite different. In both sectors, Born Digital is huge.
Your favorite?
Yes, very much unsolved issues, probably in the entire planet for Born Digital materials. Huge amount of work going on, of course, in certain areas, but across a population of institutions like these, it's concentrated in very few of them. Very much like in the US and Canada, there's a very deep perception that special collections and archives have work to do in order to align themselves with their parent institution's missions and to reach all of the requisite audiences and just really show their value, as well as the fact that there is a very much recognized need for a lot of reskilling of the population to take on new kinds of activities, such as managing Born Digital materials.
Right. Well, I look forward to hearing all about next steps and outcomes, but in the meantime, why don't you tell people where they can find your fabulous report?
Like all of our OCLC research reports, it's available open access on our OCLC research website, and here's the URL, so go get it, folks. Or you can feel very free to contact either Merrily or me, and here's our contact information. Thanks, Merrily.
We'll see you next time.